Today we are going to start the molecular basis of inheritance. Molecular basis of inheritance, this is the topic, belongs to the molecular biology. And the in the 20th century, the scientists were mostly concerned on to the molecules which are genetically giving information to the one generation to the next generation. They focused on them. So based on that, in molecular basis of inheritance, we are studying the DNA, RNA as well as proteins. Okay. So here today we are studying the DNA. So when you take the cell, so the cell is the unit and functional and structural unit of the life. So the cell is composed of the nucleus. Within the nucleus, the chromatin material is present. The cell, and within the cell, the nucleus is present. So the nucleus is composed of chromatin material. So the chromatin material is major constituent and important constituent for the inheritance. The chromatin material during the cell division, the chromatin material is condensed in the form of chromosomes. What is chromosome? Chromosome is nothing but it is a inheritance vehicle. So it carries the genetic information from one generation to the next generation. Hence, the chromosomes are called as vehicles of inheritance. So how they are formed means, generally in the cell the chromatin is present, and the presented chromatin during the cell division, it is condensed into the thread-like structures. The thread-like structures are called as a chromosomes. So how the chromosome chemically, what is the chemical composition of the chromosome? So the chemical composition of the chromosome basically two. So one is a part of protein, another one is nucleic acid. So here the chromosome is made up of protein and nucleic acid. So here the inheritance is completely based on to the nucleus, nucleic acid. Previously our scientists are they got idea about the proteins. They concluded that the proteins the proteins are the inheritance material, but recent discoveries have discovered the nucleic acids are act as a inheritance material and genetic material. The nucleic acids are again divided into the two types, DNA and RNA. What is DNA and what is RNA? So nucleic acid is present in the nucleus. It is in the acidic state. Who discovered it means, in the year 1869, scientist Mischer identified and isolated the nucleic acid from human cell as well as fish sperm. So from human cell and fish sperm, he identified and he isolated the whitish color substance. So the white color substance, he given the name as nuclein. But later he discovered it is in acidic condition. So because of its acidic property, the name has derived as nucleic acid. From that period, the study of nucleic acid is come to the dais and it make more interested into the nowadays. So how the nucleic acid is formed means, the nucleic acid is present into the cell. So nucleus, so it is again divided into the two forms, DNA and RNA. What is DNA and what is RNA? DNA is nothing but of deoxyribonucleic acid. So whereas RNA is nothing but of ribonucleic acid. So what is the difference between these two? Means here the ribose sugar is present in both DNAs, but the both nucleic acids. Within the DNA, the ribose sugar is, the type of ribose sugar is deoxyribose sugar is present in DNA. Whereas in RNA, so the presence of the sugar, that is ribose sugar. So this is the major difference between the DNA and RNA. So where they are present? So generally the DNA is present in the living organism. It is a stable genetic material. It is present in plants, animals, bacteria, and it also present in T2, T4, T6 bacteriophages, and it is in the form of double stranded. So that's why we write as dsDNA. dsDNA means double stranded DNA. But you see, pi into 174 bacteriophage. In it, the state of the DNA is single stranded. So hence we write as ssDNA. It means naturally DNA is double stranded, but exemption. So you are seeing here pi into 174 bacteriophage. In it, single stranded DNA is present. Okay, so that is about the DNA. So what are the key components present in the DNA? So basically, what is the definition of the DNA? Means the DNA is nothing but a polynucleotide. Polynucleotide means here many nucleotides. It means polymer of nucleotide. So polymer of nucleotides. So what type of nucleotides they are? Deoxynucleotides. So it means monomers of nucleotides are combinedly formed as DNA, that is nothing but of polymer of deoxynucleotides DNA. So what are the key components present in it? Means basically three key components are present. One is phosphoric acid. So here the phosphoric acid is in the form of H3PO4. Here three OH active groups are present. Out of three active OH groups, two OH groups are combined with sugar to maintain sugar phosphate backbone. And this is the one key component. What is the next key component? Ribose sugar. So what type of ribose sugar it is? Deoxyribose sugar. So when you come to the sugar structure, so that is in the form of ribose sugar. So this, you are seeing here the structure of it. So this is the first carbon, and this is the second carbon, and this is third, fourth, and fifth. So here at the second carbon, the OH group is absent. So you see here the relationship between the OH and C, this is like. So it means at the second place the OH is absent. It means one oxygen group is absent. That's why we said as 2-deoxyribose sugar is present. But you are seeing in RNA, that is also consists of ribose sugar. The ribose sugar is full of OH. So CH OH OH H H OH CH2OHH. So you see here at the second carbon, it composed of OH in the ribose sugar. So that is like, and when you see in the deoxyribose sugar, one carbon oxygen molecule is absent. So that's why we are writing the 2-deoxyribose sugar. What is 2- indicate? 2- indicate the location of the carbon. So the carbon, the second carbon, is lost to the one oxygen molecule. Hence it is turned into the 2-deoxyribose sugar. So that is present into the one of the key components of the DNA. Another key component of the DNA are nitrogen bases. So what are the nitrogen bases? Nitrogen bases are nitrogen consisting heterocyclic compounds. Heterocyclic compounds. How many types of the nitrogen bases are present in DNA? Means basically two types of the nitrogen bases are present according to the structure. So they are purines and pyrimidines. Purines and pyrimidines. How they are differentiated? How they are differentiated means when you come to the structure of the purine, how they are means they have two cyclic rings, heterocyclic rings. So this is the purine structure. So it is composed of carbon as well as nitrogen compounds. So when you take, this is the first carbon, second, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. So it is composed of carbon, nitrogen, carbon, nitrogen, carbon, carbon, nitrogen, nitrogen and carbon. So this is the basic skeleton of the purine. And when you come to the pyrimidine, it has single heterocyclic ring. And it is also composed of carbon as well as nitrogenous compounds. So again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the basic skeleton is comprised with N, C, N, C, C, C. So this is the pyrimidine. So basic skeleton of pyrimidine. So I told two types of the nitrogen base.